Bishop Thomas Paprocki of Springfield, Illinois, is barring two lawmakers who led the passage of a pro-abortion law from receiving communion. And he says anyone who voted for that bill should not receive Holy Communion in his diocese. We will talk with His Excellency in just a moment. But first, we go to correspondent Jason Calvi for more on this story. Good evening, Jason.
Good evening, Lauren. Bishop Paprocki bars the State House Speaker and Senate President. It's an ongoing debate whether Catholic politicians who support abortion should be barred. The church says it's a serious sin, but there are plenty, including Joe Biden, who say they're personally opposed, but won't dictate what others do.
Hey, Joe.
A Catholic who backs abortion leads the field of 2020 Democratic presidential candidates. Joe Biden's rivals criticize him for not going far enough.
The vice president is absolutely wrong on this one.
Biden does support the Hyde Amendment, which bans taxpayer funds from going to most abortions.
I'm out there fighting against the Hyde Amendment because I think that's what's right for women. We always have to make this clear. Every time we deny access to women to a lawful abortion, it means that people who don't have money, people who are in very challenging circumstances, people who are frightened, are the ones who don't get access.
Biden's not the first Catholic backing abortion to run for president. It became an issue in 2004 with Democratic nominee John Kerry. U.S. bishops then debated if pro-abortion Catholic lawmakers should be barred from communion. At their June 2004 general meeting, they wrote, "Given the wide range of circumstances involved in arriving at a prudential judgment on a matter of this seriousness, we recognize that such decisions rest with the individual bishop in accord with the established canonical and pastoral principles." Cardinal Raymond Burke has pushed to deny communion.
It is the body, blood, soul, and divinity of our Lord Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. And I simply wouldn't approach to receive Holy Communion if I was in the state of sin, and neither would I give Holy Communion to someone who I knew was in the state of sin.
On the other hand, former Los Angeles Archbishop Cardinal Roger Mahoney wrote, "The Archdiocese will continue to follow church teaching, which places the duty of each Catholic to examine their consciences as to their worthiness to receive Holy Communion. That is not the role of the person distributing the body and blood of Christ." The church's canon law teaches others obstinately persevering in manifest grave sin are not to be admitted to Holy Communion. And St. Paul writes in 1 Corinthians, "Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread or drink the chalice of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and of the blood of the Lord."
And we have the reaction of one of those being barred. Illinois Speaker of the House Mike Madigan says he was warned about it before allowing the House to debate the abortion bill. He says he believes it is more important to protect a woman's right to choose. Lauren?
Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi. Thank you, Jason.